And welcome to worship, especially to all of you who braved the weather this morning. Not a whole lot of you braved it, so let's just start by giving yourselves a round of applause for getting here so soon. And to you at home, it's okay. We understand you're here in spirit. Next week. Let us begin worship with standing as you are able for our gathering hymn as we gather at your table. Like lost sheep, we have gone astray. We gaze upon abundance and see scarcity. We turn our faces away from injustice and oppression. We exploit the earth with our apathy and greed. Free us from our sin, gracious God. Listen when we call out to you for help. Lead us by your love to love our neighbors as ourselves. Amen. All have sinned and fall short of the glory of God. By the gift of grace in Christ Jesus, God makes you righteous. Receive with glad hearts the forgiveness of all your sins. Let us pray. Eternal light, shine in our hearts. Eternal wisdom, scatter the darkness of our ignorance. Eternal compassion, have mercy on us. Turn us to seek your face and enable us to reflect your goodness through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord. Amen. You may be seated, and the children are invited forward for children's time with Gloria.
All the difference in the world. So what I'm asking you to do is speak up when you have a need that you want heard. If you can't talk to someone, then you talk to Jesus and you tell him what your problem is. It can never be too much for him to listen to. And for all of you, I want you to search out those kids that need a friend. Maybe it's you. And I want you to be like Jesus. Listen to him. Be there for him. And you know what? That doesn't just apply to you. It applies to all of you. We all can make a difference. And that's what I want for you this week. Make a difference. Know Jesus is there and make a difference. Okay. We're going to go have fun.
The first reading today is from Jeremiah chapter 31, beginning at the 7th verse. Thus says the Lord, sing aloud with gladness for Jacob, and raise shouts for the chief of the nations. Proclaim, give praise, and say, save, O Lord, your people, the remnant of Israel. Say, I am going to bring them from the land of the north and gather them from the farthest parts of the earth, among them the blind and the lame, those with child and those in labor together. A great company, they shall return here, with weeping they shall come. And with consolations I will lead them back. I will let them walk my brooks of water in a straight path to which they shall not stumble. For I have become a father to Israel, and Ephraim is my brother. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
Take your mask off.
Today's second reading is from Hebrews chapter 7, beginning at the 23rd verse. The former priests were many in number because they were prevented by death from continuing in office. But he holds his priesthood permanently because he continues forever. Consequently, he is able for all time to serve those who approach God through him, since he always lives to make intercession for them. For it was fitting that we should have such a high priest, holy, blameless, undefiled, separated from sinners, and exalted above the heavens. Unlike the other high priests, he has not found, he has no need to offer sacrifices day after day. First for his own sins, and then for those of the people. This he did once for all, when he offered himself. For the law appoints as high priests those who are subject to weakness, but the word of the oath, which came later than the law, appoints a son who has been made perfect forever. Word of God, word of life.
Thanks be to God.
To St. Mark.
Glory
As Jesus and his disciples and a large crowd were leaving Jericho, Bartimaeus, son of Timaeus, a blind beggar, was sitting by the roadside. When he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to shout out and say, "Jesus, son of David, have mercy on me." Many sternly ordered him to be quiet. But he cried out even more loudly, "Son of David, have mercy on me." Jesus stood still and said, "Call him here." And they called the blind man, saying to him, "Take heart, get up, he is calling you." So throwing off his cloak, he sprang up and came to Jesus. Then Jesus said to him, "What do you want me to do for you?" The blind man said to him, "My teacher, let me see again." Jesus said to him, "Go, your faith has made you well." Immediately, he regained his sight and followed him on his way. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, O Christ.
And little six-year-old Gabby wanted something signed too. But she she didn't have any. Finally, after careful consideration, she agreed that if she had a chance, maybe a player could sign her Rapunzel hat that she was wearing. But by the time she got in line, the stairs were filled. They were packed. And she was about 8 to 10 of those wide steps back from the fence. She just looked wide-eyed and quietly, seemingly coming to grips with the idea that it just wasn't going to happen for her. And accepting that this was the way it was. But Trevor Brown took a ball from the dugout, signed it with someone else's Sharpie, and pointed back at her, and had all the boys pass a ball back to her. She was elated. Later on, I took a picture of her and sent it to him on social media, thanking him. And he even wrote back. That night, she slept with the ball. And from then on, she was Trevor Brown's greatest fan, always cheering more loudly than anyone for him. It makes a difference to be seen, especially in this world where so often there's a mob of bigger and louder people who would take the focus. That's how it was for Bartimaeus in Mark's gospel today. Bartimaeus could no longer see. And at that time and place, there wasn't any such thing as state disability or welfare or the society of the blind or even seeing eye dogs. He had been able to see at one point, so he knew what he was missing. But now he was confined to sitting by the roadside outside Jericho, just begging for scraps from merciful strangers. Thankfully, Bartimaeus still had his hearing, so he could hear the people walking by murmuring and whispering and the excitement of knowing and hearing that Jesus of Nazareth was nearby. Well, Bartimaeus had heard about this Jesus, and he was not about to miss his chance. So he began yelling and cheering and pleading and crying out and making radical political claims about Jesus being the son of David. But just like that mob of boys at the baseball game, the crowds had an advantage of being able to see Jesus and being able to wiggle and push their way to the front. And they tried hushing Bartimaeus. It just wasn't going to happen for him. He needed to just accept that this was his life now. But Jesus saw Bartimaeus. Had drawn a line to exclude Bartimaeus. But as it has been said, whenever we draw a line to exclude someone, Jesus goes over to the other side of the line and stands with them and then invites us to come join him there. Every time. Jesus sees those who are invisible to the rest of the world. He hears those who have been silenced. He is with those who have been told that they're not good enough, they're in the way, they shouldn't dare ask for more than they already have. And he brings hope and healing and wholeness. Jesus is with us when we feel alone, when it seems the world has pushed us out, when our hearts are broken, when it's all we can do to get through to the next day, when Jesus saw Bartimaeus, he asked the sign ball forward. And then he called Bartimaeus to him and asked him what he wanted. And even though Bartimaeus had probably seen Jesus more than anyone else that day, Jesus restored his sight. Now, Bartimaeus wasn't the only one Jesus gave sight to that day. You see, just as that mob of boys hadn't seen, hadn't noticed tiny 6-year-old Gabby, and probably could have easily trampled her and not paid attention, this crowd had just 2 minutes earlier told Bartimaeus to keep quiet. But Jesus helped them to see Bartimaeus. And they helped him forward. And they recognized that he mattered. And they witnessed a miracle, all the while experiencing their own miracle. You see, it's not so much that Jesus loved Bartimaeus any more than anyone else in the crowd that day. He didn't. He loved him, but he loved everyone else in the crowd. But it's that when someone has been told over and over again that they don't matter, when they've been taught that they are not wanted, when they have been excluded and told, no, you shouldn't be here, when they have been taught that there's something wrong with them just for being who they are, and that they must be a sinner because God would never let someone like Bartimaeus go blind if he wasn't a sinner. It makes sense. That was the way they thought back then. When that happens, then it's up to the rest of us to go over and above and beyond and out of our way to change, to welcome, to affirm. When Jesus opened the eyes of the crowd that day and they began to see Bartimaeus, when they recognized him as an equal, as a sibling, as a valuable member of their community, they found healing. And they became a part of the miracle. The good news today, the promise that we hear, or maybe that we see, is that Jesus sees all the Bartimaeuses and the Gabbies. That he sees us when we are vulnerable, when we can't see, when the world doesn't seem to see us. But maybe the best good news today, the even better promise, is that Jesus offers to open our eyes, if we are willing, to the Bartimaeuses and the Gaddies. And when our eyes are open, we will see Jesus standing there with them, inviting us to come over, calling to us to pass the ball. I invite you now to stand as you are able for the hymn of the day.
Reconciliation among all nations.
creature. That peace extends in every direction. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Healing One, we give you thanks for all who labor for the health of others. Comfort and strengthen all who struggle with chronic pain. Send healing and relief to all who are sick. Today we especially lift up to you Maverick, Audrey, Kathy, Jason, Carly, Kit, pronounced Kev, Adam, Julie, Leonard, Isaac, Ron, and Jasmine. We also lift up to you all who displaced from the fire, hurricanes, and the first responders, the people of Afghanistan and our military. Please bring wisdom, guidance, and discernment to all our world leaders to help bring peace. We now lift up to you those we name before you now. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Providing One, we give you thanks for all who provide for others. Inspire generosity in your people so that we carry out the work of making disciples of all nations. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Living One, we give you thanks for the saints who have increased our faith. Give us courage to follow in hope until you gather us all around your table of abundance. Hear us, O God.
Your mercy is great.
Confident that you hear us, O God, we boldly place our prayers into your hands. Through Jesus Christ, our truth and life.
Amen.
The peace of the Christ be with you always.
And also with you.
Let us share that peace with one another. Get your pool noodle.
Thank you.
stand as you are able?
Let us pray. God of abundance, you cause streams to break forth in the desert and manna to rain from the heavens. Accept the gifts you have first given us. Unite them with the offering of one of our lives to nourish the world you love so deeply. Through Jesus Christ, our Savior and Lord.
Amen.
Body of Christ, given for you. body of Christ given for you. The 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 body of Christ given for you. Body of Christ given for you. The 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 body of Christ given for you.
Now may the body and blood of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ strengthen you and keep you in his grace. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord of
Lord
life,
of life
and the gift of your body and blood,
and the eternal promise of our Savior in the peace of salvation, send us forth into the world with tongues of joy, during
candy. I mean, the decorating the trunks is fun, but so we're inviting, you know, everybody from the neighborhood and anyone else you know to come and trunk or treat with us from 5 to 7 p.m. Saturday evening. And then Sunday morning is really exciting next Sunday because it's Reformation Day and Reformation Sunday. So it's kind of like the birthday of the Lutheran Church, and you'll hear all about it, but I'm inviting all of you to wear red if you have it, or a Halloween costume. You can go either way. Have fun. I want to see both. Or a red Halloween costume. See how creative you all are. So it's going to be a fun day, and I decided I'm going to have a fun little treat towards the end of that service. So you need to come and see. Let's see. Oh, and pictures for All Saints Day. So last year, when we couldn't be together for All Saints Day, a number of you sent me pictures that you wanted included, and we had kind of a video montage of some of our beloved saints, some people who were members here at Calvary, some people who are just your family and your saints. So to give me a little time, by next Sunday, if you want somebody in that photo montage that we'll try to play, get me their picture. Preferably text it to me is the easiest way. If not, email it to me. And then we can include them in our All Saints honoring. Let's see. Are there any other... Yes. Yeah. If you send them to me last year, don't send them to me again. That'll get confusing. But if you have new ones, send me those. So, any other announcements? Wow, it's quiet. Okay. I'm going to ask you all.
Maybe I'm going to say one more. On November the 2nd Saturday,
Jesus and His glory, the Jesus and His word.
mercy.